Dear students, we learned about the Earth as a planet. Did you ever think about the interior of the Earth? How it will be? What we can see in the interior? During this lockdown period, my daughters were watching a film named A Journey to the Center of the Earth. It was an interesting film. Did you ever think about a journey to the center of the Earth? Today, we can start a journey to the center of the Earth. We are going to study about the Earth's structure. In this lesson, we will learn about the structure of the Earth. How geographers study about the interior of the Earth? Study of the materials like magma, ashes, smoke, and the many gaseous substances and rocks thrown up by volcanoes help us to know the materials inside the earth. During an earthquake, seismic waves come to the earth's surface. Primary, secondary, and long waves come to the surface of the earth related with the materials they are moving through. Scientific instruments which record these waves helps to study the density, pressure, and temperature of the interior of the earth. Keeping in mind the theories of the origin of the Earth, for example, the Big Bang theory, scientists study meteorites which fall on the surface of the Earth. The Earth is said to be constituted of the same material as the meteorites. When we peel an onion, it is having many layers. Like that, Earth is also constituted of many layers. The more important layers of the earth are crust, the outermost layer, below the crust lies mantle, and the inner layer is known as core. Let us study in detail about these three layers of the earth's interior. So when we study about these three layers, we will study about the composition, thickness, temperature, and density of each and every layer. Crust or the lithosphere is the thin outermost layer of the earth. Crust is called lithosphere because it is a sphere of solid rocks. Crust can be divided into two, sial and sima. Sial, it forms the continental crust. Sima, it makes the ocean floor. Sial is formed of silicon and aluminium. That's why it got the name as sial. Sima is formed of silica and magnesium. Thus, its name is sima. The average density of sial is 2.7 gram per cubic centimeter. Sima, its density is 3 to 3.4 gram per cubic centimeter. So you may be understood that sial is having low density than the sima. Sial appears to float above sima because it has less density. So sial, it floats over sima. That means the continental crust is floating over the ocean floor. What are the features of the crust? Now let us check the each and every feature. The composition of the crust is made up of rocks, which contains silicates, feldspar, mica, aluminium, and magnesium. Thickness, 60 km below high mountains. That means it is the thickness of the continental crust, and 5 to 10 km below the oceans. It is the thickness of the ocean floor. Temperature, upper part of the oceanic crust is 0 degree Celsius and increases with depth and ranges between 600 degree Celsius to 1200 degree Celsius. Density, continental crust 2.7 gram per cubic centimeter, and density of oceanic crust is 3 to 3.4 gram per cubic centimeter. We know that The Earth's crust undergoes many changes. What may be the reasons for these changes? The changes are mainly related to the forces of nature. Forces of nature means the action of wind, rain, river water, glaciers, etc., etc. Due to the movement of tectonic plates, it undergoes structural changes, means the formation of mountains, block mountains, etc. And lateral movements give the earth a new shape very slowly, means the movement of the tectonic plates that leads to the formation of ridges, trenches, volcanoes, etc. So these changes are taking place very slowly through millions of years. Below the crust, the second layer is mantle. In between the crust and mantle, there lies a discontinuity. It is named as Mohorovic discontinuity. It forms a boundary between the crust and the mantle. Here, when the earthquake waves change speed, it is found at a depth of about 8 km below the oceans and about 32 km below the continents. Mohorovic discontinuity has the characteristics of both crust and mantle.